High-speed internet, or broadband internet, is becoming increasingly more essential for the growth of business in the digital age. But in rural America, like here in Scottsville, Virginia, the average internet speed is roughly 2 times slower than the rest of the state, and over 4 times slower than the national average. And that is harming businesses that are struggling to grow beyond the roads of this small town.
Heather Stertzer is the owner of Scottsville Supply Company, a store that sells beekeeping equipment and products made from local bees. Using her cable internet in her shop downtown, Heather can sell her products anywhere in America through her store's website. But when she goes home to residential Scottsville, she's unable to work at all because she has no access to the internet.
Once I go home, the business has to stop.
Heather is like millions of small rural business owners whose productivity and profits are harmed by the lack of rural high-speed internet. If she had high-speed access at home, she could grow her internet business there and focus on her retail sales downtown. Instead, she has to do both at the shop.
Everything has to be done during the time that I'm physically here in the store. Mm-hmm. But that time is also reserved for my customers when they walk in the front door and need help or need a product.
Rural internet speeds in America are slower than the average speeds of most developing countries. That's mostly because those countries classify high-speed internet as a public utility and even subsidize the internet. The U.S. has given the job of delivering high-speed internet to highly unregulated private companies. So why haven't those companies brought broadband to Scottsville?
The cynical one-word answer is the market.
Dr. Christopher Alley is a professor at UVA and an expert on rural broadband policy. He explains that due to the high cost of fiber optic cables, large telecommunications companies have no financial incentive to wire sparsely populated rural areas.
It's frustrating for a lot of people, and you know, I have some friends in the area who have kids that go to the public schools, and they get school assignments that require internet access, and so they have to drive their kids to the Scottsville Public Library or perhaps the coffee shop.
One of the ways in which we can make rural America competitive is high-speed broadband. And that's not a joke, and it's not just about Netflix. It's about quality of life. It's about allowing a university student to telecommute in or take classes online, or a high school student to watch videos. It's about, you know, a doctor, Skyping with a patient, right? None of this would be possible without high-speed broadband. And yes, it is about watching Netflix, right? Rural residents have a right to their Netflix as much as you and I do.
Given its location off the James River, Scottsville was historically a port town and hub for businesses. But without high-speed broadband and any plan to implement it in the near future, Scottsville business owners and residents cannot grow, compete, or innovate in the digital age and economy.